Hello and welcome to my channel. Please like, share, and subscribe if you like this video, and thank you all so much for watching. Thank you, thank you, thank you to my day ones, twos, and threes. Thank you to all my new subscribers that's coming in. That means well. Thank you so very much. I appreciate you all, and welcome, welcome, welcome. This video is for entertainment and educational purposes only, so everything is alleged. Some is not, and the Fair Act use is in my description box, y'all. So let's get to it, y'all. Now, first I want to say happy Thursday, y'all. I hope everybody is having a wonderful day, and please stay safe out here. It's a lot going on out here, y'all. Now, I know I have been preoccupied lately, okay, but I've been putting some stuff together for you all. People have been sending me videos from other bloggers, all kind of stuff, and I had to go back because I was like, something is missing. Something is seriously missing with everything that everybody's putting out right now. Is something missing? And I was like, let me go back. And I had to go back into my little archive, y'all. Okay. And I had to see, how does these cases connect? Okay. This was my whole thing in putting this video together. Now I got a lot of pictures and posts, so I'm going to try to go on and get to it as fast as I can. Okay, y'all. Now, first off, I want to say, rest in peace to Dolph, because Dolph seemed like he's about to get some justice, y'all. And I, Lord have mercy, I can't wait till Mo3 get his turn, okay? But Dolph is about to get some justice, and heads is about to turn, and a lot of people is about to, you know, go down for this. And I know that there's some strategies taking place right in front of our face right now with Jay-Z, with Yo Gotti, Moneybagg Yo. It's a lot of strategies taking place right now. Okay, I want y'all to pay attention. That people is looking like they're planning to leave the country. And some people is looking like they're planning to take over where they left off when they leave. Are they really into it, Jay-Z and Yo Gotti? Or is this a play? Is this a chess move? Okay, now let's get to Dolph, all right? Now, my thing is right now, and I'm just going to be completely honest with you all. My whole thing right now is, I do believe that the men tried and tried and tried and tried to take Dolph out. And it took some women to do it. It took some women to put a play together for Yo Gotti now, allegedly, to take Dolph out. And my thing is, I believe these two women right here were the masterminds, mainly the one to the right. But I do believe that they were the ones who called themselves Sit Back and planned out Dolph's demise. Okay. And then when they brought the guys in on it, everybody was like, it sounded like a good plan. Okay. And all they needed was the money and the place to do it. Okay. Now, on the left, you have Yo Gotti and you have Anita Wilson, okay? And on the right, you have Kamisia, something like that, Henderson White, okay? And these two women right here are very important when it came down to what went down with Dolph. And we all been trying to figure out, how do Dolph's demise and, you know, Anita Wilson's demise, how do these cases connect? And I think I figured it out, y'all. I really do. I think I figured it out. Now, on one hand, you can say these two women are friends. Okay? They're friends. They OGs, to be exact, y'all. Both of these women are OGs. Are they friends or are they related? Is the question. Now, I want you to pay attention to the moles in their face, the nose, small lips and stuff like that, little peanut heads. I want you to pay attention to that, all right? That they could be related. And if they're not related, they got to be some street, y'all, I'm telling y'all, street associates in some kind of way related, okay? Now, Anita Wilson, she's best friends with Yo Gotti's mother. Okay, y'all? And this all is starting to come together and make sense as to why the police and everything was guarding Yo Gotti's mother's restaurant. when this whole thing went down, because they knew it was all connected from the start. They knew that there was going to be people try to come back at Yogati Nim, and they covered up that restaurant, you know, and made sure that, you know, she closed down early or didn't open up because of this whole incident that was taking place. Now, everything is starting to make sense, y'all. Now, the people to the right is Kamishia, I hope I'm saying her name right, Kamishia Henderson White, and lo and behold, Moneybagg Yo. Okay, y'all? Now, I want y'all to pay attention to something else, okay? Moneybagg Yo, allegedly, he was signed to CMG for $200,000. This is what they said. That when Yo Gotti signed Moneybagg Yo, only thing he gave him was $200,000. So, I told y'all they get these guys crumbs to sign with them, okay? Now, the thing that gets me is, okay, and I got this from another blogger, that for Moneybagg Yo's birthday, and I posted about this a long time ago, okay? And this is one thing that I got to stop and say real quick, y'all. A lot of my information that I'm about to give you all is from several different people, bloggers. My stuff that I did, stuff that, you know, another blogger did and another blogger, okay? But this is where I have a problem with, because I can't stand when somebody is so arrogant and they act as if everything is their work. And that they put everything together by themselves, okay? I can't stand that, okay? Because it takes a village. It takes a village to bring down some demons. And it takes a village to raise some kids, okay, y'all? The right way. So all of this, oh, this is mad. I told y'all I'm the best and this and that. I cannot stand that junk, okay, y'all? Because everybody gets information from each other. And this is how they put stuff together, okay? Now, Moneybagg Yo, for his birthday, Yo Gotti gave him $1.5 million for his birthday. But he only signed him for $200,000. So ask yourself this question, do that make any sense? Now, if he gave Moneybagg Yo $1.5 million, was this the money to take Dolph out? This is the question that everybody been talking about. That this was the money that was paid to Moneybagg Yo to pay off all the hitters that was about to take Dolph out. Okay, y'all? This is what this money was used for. Okay? This is what they're saying. Allegedly. Okay? Which makes sense, because if you only signed him for $200,000, why would you give him this much money for his birthday? Okay, y'all? Don't make sense, y'all. So this ties in Yo Gotti to being the person that dropped the bag on Young Dolph. Okay? Now, we got the money. Now we need the place. Okay? So it made sense that Makita's, okay, was the place to set him up, because this is where he comes to all the time. He supported their business, okay? But I told y'all before, you got to be careful of who you support, because when you support somebody, okay, and they snakes and they hang around snakes and they are out here doing all kind of stuff to get their name out here, you have to be careful of stuff like this. I told y'all this. This female right here, she was all on Jerry Springer shows. She was on all kind of mess, Cheaters or something like that. I don't know. She was on all kind of mess that she was trying to get on TV. She was trying to do whatever it is that she needed to do. Okay. She had, you know, dancing, you know, and, you know, adult entertainment stuff. She was into this type of stuff, okay? So when you have a person that's trying everything they can do to get a place out here and be put on the forefront, you have to be careful about stuff like that, because it could backfire on you, okay? I stay away from people that want to be so out in the open with everybody and be friends with everybody. You have to be careful of people like this, okay? So they needed a place, and it makes sense now that her place was the place chosen. Okay, y'all? Now, remember when I went back and I did numerology? Let's go back for a second. Remember when I did numerology and I brought up the Makitas, and I was like, in numerology and Greek mythology and numerology, I said that Makitas was connected to the Queen of Sheba and all of that. And I told y'all the story about the Queen of Sheba and stuff like that, and it was connected. And then later on, somebody went and did some digging, okay? And they found out that this was something that they used to, you know, tease about being the Queen of Sheba stuff in their background, the background of the Makita's cookies, okay? So things were tying together when I was doing all of that, okay? Now that they got the place, because she was all for it, and she's friends with the circle of people that had something to do with this, okay? Y'all, I told y'all, she was lying from the start. Not only was she lying, she had her mama lying, okay? But her mama messed up on the news, okay? They had to get the players together. They had to get the people together that had a little animosity against Dolph, that were jealous of Dolph, that was feeling like Dolph wasn't doing enough for them, okay? Now, in this picture right here, you have up to the top, to the right guy, the right side at the top, you have Treon, okay? AKA Big Wop, okay? Big Wop is the person that was caught with the weapon, okay? He was caught later on with a weapon. And the same weapon that allegedly that he got caught with was the weapon that connected him to the Covington people, okay? Anita Wilson and Darnisha McLeod, okay? When they got hit up coming from the game, his weapon connected him to that, okay, y'all? Now, at the bottom, to the left, we have Paper Route Wu, okay? So, Paper Route Wu is a snake, too. Remember, I did his numerology, and people that don't remember or didn't see it, I put the numbers back up again in this video so I could show y'all what was coming up in his numerology, which made sense to why him and Big Wop was friends. Okay, y'all? So, they had their players together of who all was going to be involved. Now, it makes sense as to why Paper Route Wu was smiling his butt off the day that Dolph got taken out. He was smiling his butt off when they were doing the, you know, the turkey drives. And I want y'all to remember something that I put up in a video way back when I started covering the Dolph case. I said that everybody that was doing the turkey drives, they act as if, you know, Dolph didn't matter or he was already gone. Or they knew something. Okay, they wasn't even being where they were supposed to be. They had flyers, said that they was going to be in one place, and then they were shut down and went somewhere else. Now, mind you, they had people that was on a list with their names and everything that they was passing out these turkeys to. But they shut down and went somewhere else. They was in the middle of the street just passing out turkeys somewhere else, as if they had already knew that Dolph was on his way out the door. They wasn't listening to nothing that Dolph was saying, y'all. When it came down to the turkey drives or nothing. People wasn't even answering their phone. What's his name? The Snoop, whatever his name. He wouldn't even answer his phone. He claimed he was getting his hair done when Dolph called him the morning that Dolph got taken out. And Dolph called him and he didn't answer. He said he was getting a haircut. Now, y'all know people can answer the phone when they're getting a haircut, right? He knew Dolph was going to be taken out, too. That's why he didn't answer the phone. Okay, now, allegedly, everything's alleged, all right? So, this makes sense as to why, you know, Paper Route Wu was smiling. He was in on this mess, allegedly, y'all. He was in on it, okay? Now, I want y'all to pay attention to these pictures because they're very important. Moneybagg Yo goes way back, way, way, way back with a lot of people that was, you know, entangled into this whole little thing, okay? He goes way back with these people. And allegedly, he was a part of Trula Mafia. Okay, y'all? He was a part of all this mess. Okay? Not only was Moneybagg Yo a part of Trula Mafia, but this Orange Mountain Quick guy, he's a part of Trula Mafia. Okay? Now, what connects all of these people is this woman right here, Kamisia Henderson White. Her and Orange Mountain Quinn are close. Very close, okay, y'all? Close enough to the fact that if something happens with her and she gets upset, he comes and help take care of it, okay, y'all? That's how close they are, all right? Not only is, you know, Kamisia Henderson White close to Orange Mount Quinn, but also Raven, okay? Remember I put that video out saying that, you know, they was dating or something like that, or they knew each other or family members? Well, word on the street is, they are close to Raven from Makita's. Now, she claimed that she didn't have nothing to do with none of Dolph Ops, but she is right slap in the middle of everything, okay? This is her friends list, or Orange Mound Queen's friends list, and she's on there. She's on the list. Raven is on his list, okay, y'all? Now, this just connects everybody that where it happened at and all that stuff. Now my question is, are these people right here connected? Okay. Now we know that Mia J was Dolph's baby mama. Okay. And just because somebody your baby mama don't mean that they wouldn't be a part of stuff. This happens every day. Mia, she's pretty much been taken up for Raven ever since it started. She let Raven them put cookies in their store named after Dolph and all of this stuff. Now, people often wonder, why was Raven so close to Mia? And why Mia letting, you know, Raven put Dolph cookies in her store and pick, you know, she's making money through Makita's now in Dolph's name through these cookies. Word on the street is Mia J is in business with the Makita's now. The same place where your man was taken out. Now, word on the street is, Dolph was cheating on Mia J, y'all. Which makes sense to why she did not care about them taking him out. When and at the same time that Dolph was allegedly cheating on her, Dolph had her in, you know, and her family on an allowance. So, she only could get so much money out of Dolph and her family members. Because Dolph got tired of her taking care of her whole family. Word on the street, okay? But with Dolph out the way, she's handling the money now. She's handling a lot of things. And I want y'all to pay attention to this mommy-o and daddy-o clothing line, okay? A person that daddy-o, Oreo, is who I call him. Him and Dolph was in business together. Dolph had, you know, he put Dolph on with a little money and Dolph paid that money back to him. And after he paid the money back to him, his name was supposed to be taken off of whatever. And everything was supposed to be in Dolph's name afterwards. But with Dolph being taken out and maybe the paperwork not even going through, that Daddy Oreo wasn't supposed to be on the paperwork anymore. It left Daddy Oreo in control of a lot of business that him and Dolph had already settled and he was out of. Okay. Now when Dolph get taken out the picture, Daddy Oreo and Mommy O over here, all of these people are in business in cahoots together. Allegedly. Okay, y'all. So with Dolph being out the way, it makes sense to follow the money. Now, in the middle, this is supposed to be Dolph's cousin in the middle. Now, word on the street is people were saying that Dolph, one of Dolph's cousins, was involved in him being taken out as well. Another rumor that came out is one of Dolph's cousins got taken out the same day Dolph got taken out. Okay, y'all? He got taken out the same day Dolph got taken out, but nobody reported on it or said anything about it. But allegedly, one of Dolph's cousins was in on the hit, too. So my question is, was the cousin in on this? And was Mia J in on this? Now, we all know that Dolph's brother to the right was there, too. He was the one that was hitting at the white car. But word on the street, he was shooting up in the sky. He was shooting over the car. He wasn't really shooting at the car. Okay? He wasn't really trying to hurt nobody. Okay? This is what they said. Now, mind you, remember Raven's mother, Pamela, said that Dolph and his brother was over there on the phone in the corner. But his brother didn't even get a splendor, y'all. He didn't get a splendor, okay? There was rumors that he got hit up, too. But no ambulance came to take care of the brother. And matter of fact, they took the brother and threw him in jail. Remember, y'all? They threw him in jail after Dolph was hit up. Which didn't make any sense, but that's what they did. And there was no kind of blood nowhere to say that he got hit up. Word on the street is he was involved. Okay? Now, Pamela got on the news and she lied and said him and his brother was over there in the corner. But he was the only one hit. Ask yourself why. There's so many different stories, okay? Then they say that his brother wasn't even in the store with him when he got hit up. Make it make sense, okay, y'all? This is why all the stories is all over the place. So were they involved too? Now, while all of this is going on, and they're making plans to take Dolph out, Yo Gotti is mingling and tingling with Jay-Z. At the same time, he's mingling and tingling with Jay-Z, and Jay-Z is all in his ear, y'all. Okay? Jay-Z is making plans for the takeover. But was he trying to take over, or was they all in cahoots together? When Dolph get taken out, you're going to be hot. So I'll manage your artists in case you have to leave the country. So are they really into it, or is this a play, y'all? Ask yourself this question. Is Jay-Z really backing away from Yo Gotti? Or was this all in the plan in the first place? Ask yourself this question. Because we just seen Moneybagg Yo at the brunch with Jay-Z. So everybody, like, you know, he's trying to take over his artist. You know, Glorilla, she's hanging out all at the war show, hugged up with Beyonce now. So is this a part of the play to take over his artist? But word on the street is he sold CMG to Jay-Z. This is what people are saying, that Jay-Z owns them now. And other people are saying that Jay-Z only manages CMG artists. Which one is it, y'all? Okay? Which means that there was some planning taking place. That if you get hot, I'm going to see to your artist. Which makes Jay-Z put his hand all in a cookie jar and be a part of the play as well. Okay, y'all? Now, I want y'all to pay attention to these two right here. Okay, let's get back to the OGs. Let's get back to the OGs, y'all. Okay? Now, what's puzzling to me is Kamishia Henderson White, which brings her into this play, and I got this from another blogger's page because somebody sent it to me, is she has some sons that passed away, and she blamed Dolph for it, even though Dolph didn't have nothing to do with it. But word on the street is she just a dirty as woman. She dirty, okay? And she needed somebody to point the finger at, and she wanted somebody to feel the pain that she felt because she lost her sons. Now, never mind you, the reason why she probably lost her sons is because they dirty just like she is. Now, one of her sons allegedly was on tour with Dolph. And then Dolph tried to make him stay on tour with him, but he wanted to go back home. And when he went back home, he got taken out when he went back home. But she blamed Dolph for it. And Dolph was trying to help him, okay? That's why I tell y'all, you can't help everybody. You can't even help your family members because they will bite the hand that feed them every time. You can go out and spend your money on certain people or friends, and they will be back. They'll be talking about you the next 5 minutes or throw you under the bus the next 5 minutes. And you can just been and worked all week and go bam, something real nice, and they'll turn on you, okay? And this is the same thing that she did to Dolph. Dolph was trying to help her family out by taking her son on tour. And if he took him on tour, he was going to pay him. He wanted to go back home and be in the middle of some mess. And that just goes to show you his upbringing. Because she messy, so her kids is messy. He'd rather go back to the hood and, you know, be with the street, you know, street associates, instead of be out on tour and make some money. Okay? So that just goes to show you his mad frame. Okay? But she blamed Dolph. All right? Now, Dolph comes back, and Dolph, you know, little time passes. He ends up signing somebody. When he signed this person, allegedly the person that Dolph signed was the person that took out her son. So that made her even double mad, okay? So this woman has been holding a really bad grudge against Dolph for a long time. So this was the perfect storm. You have this evil woman right here, Kamishia White. And you have Yo Gotti that Dolph been beefing with. You got his woman that, you know, she's mad because Dolph cheating on her and disrespecting her, doing songs saying that he messing with Yo Gotti's girl and all kind of stuff. So you got a whole bunch of people that's holding some animosity. And at the same time, you got a whole bunch of people holding animosity. You also have Raven, who's thirsty to get, you know, her name out there. And she's dirty. Okay? So you got a perfect storm brewing right here, y'all. And you got some guys that's about it. Orange Mound Quentin and all these people connected to these OGs, female OGs. So you got the perfect storm. And I'm going to tell y'all something. Ain't nothing harder on a woman than another woman. Okay, y'all? Another woman will take another woman out easily. Okay, especially if they got the backings of a bunch of guys. Okay, y'all? I want y'all to pay attention to this. So, another thing I want y'all to pay attention to is the fact that Moneybagg Yo, last name, is white as well. So, something that made me wonder about this whole situation was, and I kept thinking, you know, is Moneybagg Yo some kin to this woman? They got the same last name. His name is DeMario Dwayne White Jr. And her name is Camisia Henderson White. Okay? So I was like, are they related? That's the first thing that came to my mind. Are they related? Because, you know, and I'm still trying to figure it out, y'all. Are they related? Because they're very close. This woman hung out with Moneybagg Yo now. Okay? Her son was in the same street association as Moneybagg Yo and Orange Quentin them. Okay? So, y'all, this is a perfect storm right here. Do y'all see this perfect storm? Now, I'm going to try to blow this up as much as I possibly can. So, y'all can see. If I hope it don't get blurry. But DeMario Dwayne White Jr., this is Moneybagg Yo's real name. Okay? Now, this Camisia Henderson White, this is a post that she put out. And she was, you know, posting back and forth to Orange Mount Quentin. She was posting to him right before Dolph got taken out. And this is something that caught my eye. She said, people crossed me. I didn't cross them back. I just crossed them out. Now, allegedly, she was talking about Dolph on this. But if you think about when she say people, that means anybody that crossed her, she crossed them out. So, which takes you to another place, y'all. Okay? It takes you to Anita Wilson. Did Anita Wilson cross her? And this is why she was the target. Now, a lot of people were saying that Darnisha was the one that was the target. But I don't think Darnisha was the target. I think Anita Wilson was the target. And I told y'all why when I ran the numbers in her numerology. Now, I want y'all to remember that the police put a statement out saying that June the 1st, 2021 and March 1st, 2022 in Shelby County, this is when they started planning, March the 1st, 2020, they started planning Dolph to get taken out. This is what they're saying, that there were plans being put in place for Dolph to be taken out in the middle of the year, earlier middle of part of the year, that they were, this is that they were planning early in the year to take him out. Okay, y'all? And this is what they put out. Now, if you think about the time, a month later, Raven put out this post right here. I'm going to try to bring it close to y'all so y'all can read it. This post says, Young Dolph said he came to Memphis just for Makita's cookies. She posted this. Okay, now mind you, she's friends with Orange Mount Quentin and all of them too. Okay, she know all of these people. Not only is she friends with them, now No One Trigger Trey is friends with these guys as well. And he's supposed to be her artist. Okay, y'all better come shot with us. And she put an address on there and everything. And she posted Dolph, you know, coming to Makita's, y'all. Now, right before Dolph got taken out, she reposted that Dolph was coming. You know, every time he comes here, he comes to Makita's. She reposted that right before Dolph got taken out. And she posted this in July the 2nd, 2021. Excuse me, y'all. And then she turned around and she reposted it again about a couple weeks before Dolph got taken out. Which make it look as if she was sending out the call. Like everything is in play. Okay? Now, right after she posted this, Stray Drop did a video He did a video, and when he did a video, he did this video with Orange Bound quitting in the video, y'all. And this is the same person that's locked up right now for, you know, taking Dolph out too. This indictment is going to be off the chain, y'all. This is going to be huge when everything falls into place like it should. Now, I want y'all to remember this guy right here to the right that's standing next to Orange Bound Quentin. He was the first person that they picked up too. He was one of the first people they picked up and they let him back out. A lot of people say he was giving up a lot of information. A lot of people were saying he gave up information too. Okay? Y'all, this RICO is about to be off the chain. Now, let's get back to the planning of Dolph's demise. Now, a couple months before Dolph gets taken out, they're at this restaurant, allegedly Yo Gotti's restaurant, okay? Planning out what they about to do. Here's Orange Bound Quentin. Here is Straight Drop. Sitting there acting like they at a birthday party, but they was really planning for Dolph to get taken out. Now, the stupid part about this, they was keeping tab on all of this, of what they was doing, taking pictures of themselves together. The whole thing is weird, y'all, that they even kept up all this. Because this is what, a lot of this stuff that they did is the reason why they all got caught up, okay? Now, let's get to everybody and their connections. Now, this is Big Wop. This is Big Wop, the Trayon guy that got caught up with the weapon that hit up, y'all, Anita Wilson, that took Anita Wilson out and hit up Darnisha in Covington. And as you look at the bottom, it said Liked by Straight Drop, okay? So all of these guys is friends. Straight Drop is friends with Trion, and Paper Route Woo. All these guys are buddies, y'all. All these guys is buddies. I told y'all, Dolph was smart when it came to money. But when it came to his associates that he had all around him, he wasn't smart when it came to these snakes that he was surrounding himself around, okay? Now, this is Big Wop right here to the right, to the left. And this is him to the right in the middle. That's standing next to Moneybag Yo. Word on the street is, all of these guys is Chula Mafia, y'all. All of these guys, okay? So this is how it's connecting the whole Covington case with the Dolph case, okay? Because the word on the street is, they use the same car. Now it makes sense to why they used the same car, y'all, okay? Because everybody was like, why would they use the same car? Why the heck would they? Because they all do dirt together and they use the same cars when they steal a car or whatever, or somebody give them a car, because word on the street is the car belonged to Black Youngster. That's what we heard. And then, you know, this white woman comes forth and say that it was stole from somebody she know, that it was stole from them. So we don't even know if that's true or not, because we know they got white girlfriends. So she could have came forward and just lied. Or the car could have been stolen. Okay? They steal cars. A lot of people steal cars in Memphis. Okay? So if you look at Big Wop's friends list, he's followed by CEO Jizzle 1818. He's followed by Straight Drop. He's followed by Trigger Trey. And Trigger Trey is attached to Raven. She's supposed to be his manager, y'all. This is her artist. So now, Raven not only is attached to Orange Bound Quentin, the person that's locked up for taking Dolph out, her and her artist is tied to Straight Drop, y'all, a person that's locked up as well. Do y'all see? The feds are coming for Makita's, them too. Okay? They can't be left out of this. They cannot be left out of this. They've been lying since this whole thing started. Okay? And word on the street is Trigger Trey was there too at the scene. Okay, y'all? That's what they said. He was there too. Okay? So let's keep going. Now, this is the three guys that is locked up for Dolph right now. Okay, Cornelius, I forgot the other guy name. Cornelius, Straight Drop, and Orange Bound Clinton. Okay, and here is AKA Big Wop over here, Trayon. Okay, so this is what connects both of these cases. Trayon is the guy that took out Anita Wilson and somebody else with him. And they used the same car Trayon used the white car. Take out Nene Wilson. Go park it somewhere and they put it up. And then they went and used the same doggone car to go take out Dolph. So now it's making sense as to why they used the same car, because they all are friends. And here's the friends list to prove that they are friends. All of them used the same car. We kept saying, why would they use the same car? Well, this don't make no sense. Now it's making sense now. Everything is starting to come to play as to why they use the same car. Okay, y'all? Now let's get back to the gangster women, y'all. Let's get back to the OGs, okay? That helped put this whole thing into play. And I told y'all, pay attention to these moles in her face. And Anita Wilson got moles in her face too, okay, y'all? That's why I think they some kin together. But it could be a coincidence. But it also could mean, you know, they could be friends. But I think that they're friends through street association. And I also think that they could be family, okay? And if they are family, then it makes sense as to why this whole circle of people was together in the first place, okay? So, she being very close to Orange Mound Quentin, which is Camisia Henderson. This is Camisia Henderson, okay? White. And this is, you know, Anita Wilson hanging out with none other than Yo Gotti. And like I told y'all, Anita Wilson is best friends with Yo Gotti's mother, okay? So it makes sense to why they was protecting the restaurant. They knew it was going to go down. They knew it was going to come back to them because they all put this together. Okay, y'all? And I keep telling y'all, they OGs. She OG because, you know, Anita Wilson, she got caught up with Moneybagg Yo them. She went to jail with them. Okay? They got caught with a whole bunch of street, you know, pharmacy stuff. They got caught with a whole bunch of weapons. And nobody did any time for it, which lets you know that the police help cover up a lot of stuff that they do in Memphis. Okay, y'all? So, this is letting you know the corruption that's there. They got caught up with a table full of stuff. Okay, y'all? And nobody did any time for it. Everybody got off. So, this again goes to show you that Moneybagg Yo them and Yo Gotti them, they got it, you know, they thought they had it made down there in Memphis. That they can get away with whatever. If you can get away with all of those weapons and all that street pharmacy stuff and all the other crimes that took place. Because word on the street is, y'all, that guy that was messing around with Stray Drop's girlfriend, he's some kin to the guy that was the driver in Indiana. Word on the street. Okay, y'all? So it's a whole, they've been getting away with a lot of bodies. So this is why they thought they could get away with Young Dolph too. Now, just because y'all see them at the games and all this stuff and hanging out and going out of town and out the country and stuff like that, don't mean that they not fearing that they about to go to jail, because word on the street is the feds then got involved into this case. And it's not going to be swept under the rug like they thought it was going to be. And it's a possibility that some people that help cover this up, polices and judges and stuff like that, they're going to go down too. They're about to lose their jobs. This is what I'm hearing, y'all. This indictment list is off the chain. Okay? Now, here is DeMario White when he went to jail with Anita Wilson. So Anita Wilson, she was out here bad about it. She is an OG, y'all. Not only is Anita Wilson an OG, Camelia Henderson White is an OG too. Okay? Which has the same last name as Moneybagg Yo. So it's starting to come into play now about who and what and how. All right, y'all? Now, for somebody to say people crossed me, I didn't cross them back, I just crossed them out, it takes you back to the two women that is probably friends. Most likely, they're friends or family members. Okay? If you look at their faces, I'm telling y'all, the moles, the small lips, the nose, everything lines up. That there could be some kinfolks going on between these two women. Okay? Now, she got the moles on her face as well. And she's an OG. Okay? This is the one, Anita Wilson. Now, where the crossing came in at, I do believe, is the fact that Darnisha. I don't think that Camisia Henderson White appreciated the fact that Anita Wilson was hanging out with Darnisha so hard. Because Darnisha was going with both of them. She was going with Dolph and she was going with Yo Gotti. Okay? She was going with both of them. So this is why they could care less who they hit up in that car, because she was playing Yo Gotti. And most likely she was probably running back telling Yo Gotti stuff. I mean, not Yo Gotti, Dolph stuff that Yo Gotti and them was doing. Dinesha was the middle person, okay? And I don't think that people appreciated the fact that Anita Wilson was hanging out with her, okay? Now, a lot of people are saying that, you know, Mob Wilson, which is Anita Wilson's son, was supposed to be somebody that helped take out Dolph, but he backed out. We don't know that's to be true. They could just be saying that, or it could be true. Okay, she could have told her son, I don't want you to be a part of that. Because she might not have wanted her son to get caught up in that mess. Because it was being done by somebody that's sloppy. Because we can see that Kamishia, she was putting stuff online, which was leading right back to her being involved in Dolph's case. Okay, so maybe, you know, Anita thought she was messy. Or maybe Anita was running her mouth. I don't know. Okay, but either way it go, these two women are OGs. Now, when you have two women that's OGs, that's into the streets, and they about the same age, it boils down to who's the dirtiest. Who's the one that's don't care about the other? Who's ruthless? She didn't say, you know, she didn't just mention Dolph's name or anything. Like, she said, when people cross me. So, did she feel that Anita Wilson crossed her? Talking to Darnisha. Okay, ask yourself this question. Now let's go back a little bit to when I did Anita Wilson's numerology. As y'all see, 137, 47, 160, 70. And I want to go back and do this again because I want to go in further on this. So I might do another video on this one, okay? On the numerology, because I done learned a little bit more since then. But I remember I put the crossing on there. This popped up 37, 56, 160, 61. Now, as you can see, 137 and 160 popped up. And when the crossing popped up, I thought about this when she said people crossed me. So, did Anita Wilson cross her and Yo Gotti? Ask yourself this question, okay? Did she cross both of them? Okay, the crossing came up. The observer popped up and she observed stuff because she was hanging out with Yo Gotti's mother. She's best friends with Yo Gotti's mother. Okay. Not only was she best friends with Yo Gotti's mother, she's best friends with this whole crew of people, y'all. And did they feel like she was going to mess up their plans by running her mouth? Okay. Remember hip hop music popped up under her name, which associates all the rappers together. Yo Gotti, Moneybagg Yo. This is what was involved in what took out Dolph. Okay. Under the bus. Did they throw her under the bus? Or did they feel like she threw them under the bus? But she was, you know, running her mouth or saying something. Or she made her son back out at the last minute. So she became their enemy. Instead of somebody that was down for them. That was getting in trouble with them. Getting caught up with them. She became their enemy. Okay, y'all. This is why she was taken out first. Now, did they feel like by her being so close to Darnisha that she was telling Darnisha stuff and the fact that Dolph was getting ready to come into town? Was Darnisha and Dolph planning on hooking up? And if Darnisha would have hooked up with Dolph before they took him out, would she have messed up the plans? Ask yourself this question, y'all. Would Darnisha have messed up everything that they have been planning for since almost the beginning of the year, y'all? Was she about to mess up the plans? So they had to take her out first, okay? Would kill her. That's what came up in her numerologies. So the people that she was so close to and are doing all her dirt with ended up turning on her, and they was the ones that took her out. Okay, so now it makes sense why they was doing the same. They was on the same mess, y'all. Same mess. Now let me look up something real quick for y'all. I want to read this to you all. That's why I want to look it up. Acrimonious, okay? Acrimonious. Acrimonious means anger and bitter. Okay? Angry feeling, bitter feeling. Who was angry at the time? Now, I want y'all to keep in mind, Kamishia Henderson White lost a couple sons. Not one, a couple. And she blamed Dolph. And when I was watching this other blogger's video, and he said that she had a lot of anger build up in her, it made sense as to why this came up, and I put it up there. Because something told me to put this up here. Okay? When I pulled the numbers and did the numerology on here. Okay? So who was angry and bitter? Now, we know Yo Gotti was salty at Dolph, but it was somebody else that was had some real deep down hurting feelings and hated Dolph. And it was Kamishia Henderson White, y'all. Okay? So this is why this was popping up. This is who crossed who, okay? She felt like Anita Wilson crossed her, y'all. Now, Sitting Duck popped up. Now, when I was watching this other blogger's information, he had me for a minute when he was talking about all of the stuff and what connected Orange Mount Quentin and all of the stuff. But when he got to the part where they was at the game, right before Anita Wilson and them got hit up, he said that the hitters was at the game. And they was loading up the cars and, you know, prepping to take her out in the parking lot. Okay? And he said that they mixed up the cars and they ended up taking her out when they really wanted to take out Maude Wilson. Now, that's where me and him differ. Okay? I don't think that, you know, Wilson and, her, you know, Darnisha's son was the target. I think that Anita Wilson was the target. That's who they wanted. If they wanted to take out Maude Wilson, they would have took out Maude Wilson. They wanted to take out the mouthpiece. Because they know she probably talked her son out of even being involved with the mask. They know that she was friends with Darnisha and she's running her mouth. So, when Sitting Duck popped up, was she the Sitting Duck? It came up under Anita Wilson's name, Sitting Duck. Okay, now, this other blogger said that they got footage of some of the hitters at the game, y'all. They said some of the people that took out Anita Wilson was at that game that they was at that game that they left. And then they got hit up on the way home. Okay, now, it doesn't make sense that they mixed up which car to hit up. Because they was following them. They had eyes on them. They was at the game with them. If this is true, what he's saying, then that she was definitely the target. If they followed them to the game and left the game when they left the game and followed them in the car, they had eyes on who got in what car with who and everything. Okay, y'all? So it doesn't make sense that they mixed up. Oh, that I think they was really after Maude Wilson. No, they wasn't after Maude Wilson. They was after his mother. And they was letting him know that we was taking your mama out for the fact that you backed out. And not only did you back out, your mama is best friends with her and she running her mouth. See, Anita Wilson was in the middle, y'all. She was friends with Darnisha. And then she was also friends with Yo Gotti's mom. And she had some kind of connection with Kamila Henderson. And Kamila Henderson got to the point where she not finna mess up all our plans. She got to go too. And that's why they took her out too. Okay, y'all? This is why. Fatal injury popped up under Anita Wilson's name. It didn't pop up under Darnisha's when I did her numerology. It popped up under Anita Wilson. Fatal injury. She was the one that passed away. Both of them got hit up. She was the one that passed. It was fatal. Okay? So let's keep going. Cry Me a River popped up. And remember, I was like, why is it saying Cry Me a River? Did Anita Wilson know she messed up with Kamila Henderson White? And did she know just how ruthless this woman was? That she wasn't trying to hear nothing she had to say? That it was over with for her? What did Anita Wilson say? She had to tell somebody something. And is that somebody, Darnisha, y'all? Ask yourself this question. Now, let's go to Darnisha. Darnisha McLeod. This is what popped up under hers. Telephone answering. So, I said this. She was in a car with her. Did the phone ring and somebody call Darnisha? Because this is what came up under Darnisha's name. Her phone rung. Did her phone ring in the car with Anita Wilson? Could Anita Wilson been on the phone while her phone rung? And did Dolph call Darnisha? Ask yourself this question. Did Dolph call Darnisha? Or did somebody else call Darnisha? But whatever it was, it had to do with a telephone call. Okay? So, y'all, this also popped up. Knew what he was doing. So, how did Darnisha know what somebody was doing unless Anita told her? Do y'all get it now? Why these numbers came up the way they came up? Now, like I said, we got Paper Route Wu, who is supposed to be Pri. Okay? He's friends with the same person that took out Anita Wilson. The same person that was in a stolen car or giving car from your black youngster. We don't know which one. He was in the same car that took out Dolph. Now it's making sense to why Paper Route Wu was smiling his butt off at the turkey drive when Dolph got taken out. And it also makes sense as to why he had on some gloves at the paper at the turkey drive too. Everybody else got their hands out passing out turkeys, y'all. But Paper Route Wu got on some gloves. Did he play a part in helping take Dolph out, y'all? Did he play a part with the ops and then turned around and started passing out turkeys with the other Pri members acting like nothing wasn't going on? But the only thing about that is, Paper Route Wu could not have been the only person that knew that Dolph was finna get taken out. Because a lot of Pri members wasn't doing what was they were supposed to be doing when it came down to the turkey draft. When it came down to all the plans that Dolph had made. And the Snoop Bands guy, he claimed that they was about to do a video shoot and all of this other stuff. And why would you wait till the last minute to go get your hair cut if you know you got to do a video shoot in the morning? You would have got your hair cut the night before. So a lot of these Pri members knew what was about to go down. And another thing that popped up in there was follow the money. Follow the money. Now, let's get to Paper Route Wu. As y'all remember, I did his numerology and 188 just kept popping up. But when you put in 188, 17 pops up. Dolph was taken out on the 17th, y'all. Okay? These are clues that pops up that, you know, when I'm doing a numerology, and this is how I put stuff together. Okay? And then I do, you know, Greek mythology I was putting in there. This is how I was mixing up, you know, the whole Makeda's thing and Queen of Sheba. Now, Dolph called himself the King of Memphis, y'all. So, was this a chess move? They got a queen. The queens of Memphis to get together and to put the play together, okay? And this is why it took place at Makeda's. Because Makeda's is tied to Queen Sheba. Go look it up yourself if y'all think I'm lying. Now, I did Paper Route Wu numerology. When I did his numerology, 188, 71, 163, 64 popped up. Setup, shooting popped up. Crown of Thorns popped up, which y'all know Jesus Christ had on the Crown of Thorns because, you know, he was betrayed. And this popped up under Paper Route Wu, y'all, okay? Show Me the Money popped up, and we know he money hungry. We know that, okay? He was posting up posts with Big Wop talking about, man, I'm gonna make more money than that, and this and that. They always talk about money, 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 money. Him and Big Wop. And Paper Route Wu, that's all they talked about was, you know, money. When I'm gonna get paid more than this, and I'm gonna do that and that and that. Okay, so Show Me the Money popped up. This guy is a fraud popped up. This stuff wouldn't be popping up like that for nothing, y'all. Okay, it's a reason behind all of this stuff. And I told y'all that a lot of these people, they have spiritual advisors that they go to so they can line up this numerology stuff with people's past. And that's why so many people's talking about, you know, murder by numbers, because they have people that they sit down with and do this stuff by the numbers, y'all. This is why it lines up the way it do. Follow the money popped up. And suspicious van. And remember, they said it was a suspicious van that was up there at Makita's when Dolph was taken out. Now, word on the street is, they say that 901 Trick or Trey owns a van. Or he was in the van. Or something about the van has something to do with 901 Trick or Trey. That's what I heard, y'all. I'm just saying. Okay? Evil Never Sleeps also popped up. Now, when Evil Never Sleeps popped up, that made me think about that grape guy, because a lot of people think that that grape guy that was they think that he was involved in this mess too. I don't know for sure, but I do know one thing, that Big Wop and that grape guy, they look like they could be family. They really do. Okay, and y'all remember when Grape did an interview and he said that the last time he talked to Dolph, he said that he was going home and go to sleep. Now word on the street is he didn't go home and go to sleep. He allegedly got on the flight. He was trying to go out of town and get away from the mess. That's what I heard, y'all. I don't know, but that's what I heard. Okay. And when this Evil Never Sleeps popped up, it made me think about what the grape guy said. He said that he was going home and go to sleep. That's the last time I talked to Dolph. But Evil Never Sleep popped up. Okay. Now, this is another thing that popped up, which was a serious clue right here, y'all. 188, same numbers as Paper Rye Wool. Okay. November 12th popped up. And if y'all don't know what happened on November 12th, let me refresh y'all memories. Okay. This is when Big Wop took out Anita Wilson and hit up Darnisha in that car. So for November the 12th to pop up under his name, under, you know, Paper Rye Wool name, this is all connected, y'all. Everything is a connection. And this is why I tell you it takes a village, because I took information that I had done from way back in my day ones, twos and threes. Know this, I took information from other bloggers. I mixed in with this that I felt that connected. And this is why I came up with what I came up with. So Anita and Darnisha were hit up on November 12th after leaving the football game. And like I said, this other blogger said that they got footage of them guys leaving, you know, that was in a parking lot and all of that. But remember on the news report, they said that it didn't happen at the game. It had nothing to do with the game. So if it had nothing to do with the game, why is this blogger saying that they got footage of the guys leaving there and, you know, loading up in the parking lot and all this mess, and they only got one person arrested? Ask yourself this question, okay? And like I said, this is where the other blogger went wrong at, because he said that they mixed up everybody and they thought they was hitting up Mara Wilson, but they hit up Anita. No, they didn't mix up nobody, because if they came to the game, they had eyes on these girls. They had eyes on them, making sure that they got who they wanted to get. And their main target was Anita. Did they feel like Anita was somebody that would take the whole thing down? They were messing up. They didn't mind certain people knowing, but they knew that she was going to mess up and up being close friends with Darnisha. And word on the street is, y'all, Darnisha had went out of town. She was gone. Now they're saying that Darnisha is back and she's close by. So is the court date stuff going to start? I don't know. But they're saying, and which don't make no sense to me, because Darnisha is somebody that's very important in this case. So you would think that the police or the feds would have her, you know, close by so that she can give out some information that needs to be put out. She's the only person that survived the hitting. Okay? And word on the street is she's in Texas now, y'all. That's what I heard. That she's in Texas. Now, like I told y'all that these cases were connected. So for Darnisha to be in Texas right now, it's mind-boggling right now, y'all. What's she doing in Texas? And y'all know who else is in Texas? The guy that was in the car with Straight Drop that got caught up. Okay? that allegedly set up his own family member to get taken out because he was dating Stray Drop's baby mama while he was locked up. Y'all, a lot of stuff is weird. And another thing that I've been hearing, that a lot of people been riding for Dolph. They said people think that people ain't been riding for Dolph. A lot of stuff has been going on. It's tied to people riding for Dolph, y'all. They said this is why Nooski got hit. Now, Nooski was allegedly one of Moneybagg Yo's artists. But word on the street is, he's some kin to Moneybagg Yo, too. That's what I heard. That this guy is some kin to Moneybagg Yo. But do y'all remember he got taken out? I did a video on it. There I am up there. I did a video on it. He got taken out. So this goes to show you that Moneybagg Yo played a big part in Dolph being taken out. He collected the money to pay everybody off that was a part of the hit. He collected the money. Raven them got paid through the GoFundMe. Okay? And pay attention to the fact that you could tell who played the biggest part in Dolph being taken out. Not only was, you know, allegedly Yo Gotti played a big part because, of course, he dropped the bag. But Moneybagg Yo is all in the middle of Dolph being taken out, y'all. He's very close friends with the female that hated Dolph. Okay? She accused Dolph of being the cause of her son's passing. And when she's the cause of her son's passing, they were just like her, dirty. They wanted to be about that street life. They wasn't about no making no money. And Dolph failed his own self because he was dealing with a lot of grimy people that really didn't want no help. And he was trying to help everybody. You can't help everybody. Okay? And is this why, you know, Moneybagg Yo artist or a family member got taken out? Because he played a big part in Dolph? Is this why Moneybagg Yo's alleged baby mama got taken out, y'all? Ask yourself this question. Is this why his baby mama got taken out? Because word on the street, his baby mama got taken out too. Remember, y'all? Now, Moneybagg Yo is truly mafia. Just like Orange Mount Quentin. Do y'all see how all the stuff is coming together? And this is why I tell you, this could be a play with Jay-Z and Yo Gotti right now, because Yo Gotti and Moneybagg Yo was just at this soccer game recently together. So they ain't really beefing. They trying to make it look like they beefing, but they not. You know, people is putting up, oh, black youngster is about to turn on CMG them. But they could be trying to throw black youngster under the bus to try to pin everything on him. Or he could be a part of the play as well. Okay, just to get y'all attention off of who did what to who and who. If everybody's thinking about, oh, Yo Gotti them and CMG them and black youngsters into it, which they probably could be, but at the same time, it all could be a play too, because they acting like Yo Gotti and Jay-Z is into it because of Moneybagg Yo signing with Jay-Z. But as you can see, they're hanging out at a soccer game after he went to the brunch. So this goes to show y'all that it's a lot of chess moves moving around and that a lot of people is playing the game, okay? And in the end, is a lot of people going to go to jail and Jay-Z going to go get away with, you know, all the CMG artists? Ask yourself this question. Is they going to throw black youngster under the bus to take the fall for everything so everybody else, can get away? Is this their plan? But whatever it is, it's something big or brewing right now because everything is falling into place now. A lot of information is every time they lock somebody up, something else pop up. Now, I want y'all to pay attention to the fact that, you know, they done locked up quite a few people. They done also locked up Yo Gotti's brother. They ain't really lock him up. They picked him up, questioned him, let him go. Word on the street is they picked up like youngster too and let him go. Because he made it his business to pop out. Now, no bloggers want to say, oh, I scuffed him out. I made Yo black youngster pop out. But it wasn't just that blogger. Everybody was talking about it. I put up a video, too, and I said that he had just got picked up. Word on the street, he just got picked up for questioning. But all of a sudden, he pops out saying, surprise. And when they went to the soccer game, Your guiding them says surprise too. And money bag, yo. Okay, so I want y'all to pay attention that all of that could be a play. Okay, y'all? It is getting crazy right now. And it's about to go down. It's about to hit the fan. And if the feds do their jobs, it's the police is going to go down too, y'all. It's word on the street, okay? So now it makes sense to why Big Wop, whom is Paper Route Wu's best friend, took out Anita Wilson right here at this intersection. He took her out because of this woman calling the shots. That's what I believe, okay? And Anita Wilson crossed this woman. And I do believe that, you know, she got her moles up there at the top. Anita Wilson got a mole down here by her mouth. I do believe they're family. And they use this guy to help them out, y'all. Okay? So, this is why he's locked up right now. This is some extra that I threw up. I'm almost finished. But this is some extra that I threw up. I wanted to throw this up because word on the street is these two are some kin. Okay, y'all? Word on the street is these two are some kin or something. Okay? This is what I heard. Okay? I'm just throwing this out there to y'all. This is what I heard. Don't know if it's true or not, so I'm going to say allegedly. Okay? These two I put together a while back, and I said that they look alike, okay? Was he a part of the play? Because his chain ended up on that little, you know, belt that Straight Drop had on. Now, I know they say they robbed him and took it, but, you know, it's a possibility he could have been robbed, but it's also a possibility that that was a lie, too. I don't know, okay? I don't know, because they got to make stuff look real to P. Dolph off, okay? They wanted to P. Dolph off, okay? But look at these two guys. This is the Grape guy, and this is Big Wop. Look how they look. That even their body shape is the same. They look just alike, okay? I said it back then. I think there's some kin. These two could possibly be some kin, okay? Anita Wilson and Camellia Henderson White. And she also, Camellia Henderson White, could be some kin to Moneybagg Yo, okay? This is just allegedly, okay? Now, another two that reminds me of each other, and my usually when my hair crawl up on my arm, I'm on to something. Okay, y'all? But, Paper Route Wu and Black Youngster, they have a lot of similarities. I don't know if y'all paid any attention to it. They smile, the way they act, a lot of stuff. It just reminds me of each other. So these are two that could possibly, you know, they needed some people to be on the inside with Dolph. So they keep up what Dolph was doing and saying. Okay. And this is another thing that crossed my mind. I'm going to say this really, really quickly. I was wondering, was Dolph bragging to, you know, pre-members, telling them that Darnisha was giving them information? Was he trusting certain members, telling him that Darnisha was coming back, telling him stuff? And is this another reason why they had certain people on the inside around Dolph so that they could come back and report to them about things? So I'm just saying, y'all, it's a possibility. But anyway, they do look alike. They got some similarities. They jaw when they laugh and everything. They got them same facial expressions. So I don't know, but it's a possibility, y'all. But anyway, y'all, let me know what y'all think in the comment section. Please like, share, and subscribe if you like this video. And thanks for watching, y'all. Peace.